Hello everyone, and welcome to another tutorial on PFMonitor. In this tutorial, we'll show you how to set up the ACL management of whitelists and blacklists of your pfSense firewalls in PFMonitor. What this will allow you to do is deploy a whitelist and blacklist to every pfSense unit you have registered into the system. And what that list will do is it will allow you to identify IP addresses globally that will apply to all pfSense units to be either allowed or blocked, as well as a separate sublist of IPs to allow and block on a per firewall basis. It handles all the list generation automatically. All you have to do is, through the user interface in PFMonitor, register those IP addresses to the proper place, and it will create us a unique list that includes the global entities and the per firewall entities for that firewall and load them to your pfSense automatically. I will note that the ACLs and whitelist and blacklist updating works much better if you have the check-in agent installed to your firewalls. Otherwise, it can sometimes take 24 hours for those updates to actually get filtered down into your firewalls. The check-in agent has the ability to force those lists to update on the pfSense basically at will. Without that being installed to the firewalls, they only update their lists once every 24 hours. So I definitely recommend putting the check-in agent on the firewalls so that it can push those much faster. Alrighty, let's get started. The first thing you're going to need to find is on the home page, the dashboard page. Roll down and find the ACL management section. You're going to need these two URLs, the whitelist sync and the blacklist sync. The next step is to open up your firewall and go to the firewall aliases section, which we're already in, and then click on the URLs section from there. Now I already have these two added, but I'll go through how you would add them real quick. So you would hit the Add button, and then you can name it whatever you'd like. However, I use these uniformly so that it's all the same across all my units. So you name the list. Make sure that you select URL table and not just plain URL, and then paste in the appropriate URL link. If this is a whitelist you're creating, you'd paste in the whitelist URL. If it's the blacklist, you would paste in the blacklist. Make sure to set this number to 1. You'll notice that the value after the slash is the update frequency in days. Unfortunately, by default, pfSense only has the ability to update these lists once a day. Again, that's why the check-in agent is valuable having on here. It will actually update those rules on command or anytime you change the lists. It'll actually trigger the push manually. So definitely you want to install that. You'd go ahead and save this. And then obviously you create the other one for your whatever list you haven't created yet. Again, making sure that you pick URL table as the type. And then you paste in the appropriate white or blacklist URL. And now you should have your two aliases in there, one as a whitelist, one as a blacklist. And go ahead and hit apply after that. Now, if there was an issue loading the list, the pfSense would have immediately brought up an error saying it was unable to connect to that URL. I have had that happen once or twice, and it seems to be something related to DNS on the pfSenses, but 99% of my units have not had an issue with it, so I'm thinking it's a local DNS server at that one site or two sites. I'm still looking into that, but every other unit has not had a problem setting this up. Now you might notice that the URL is the same for all of your firewalls, and you might wonder, how does the pfSense pull in a unique list if you're giving them all the same URL? And that's very simple. When your pfSense unit connects to this URL, the system checks what IP address it is coming from, the source address, which would be your pfSense's WAN interface. And based on that WAN interface, it knows which firewall is asking for a list, and it feeds back the appropriate list for that firewall automatically. That saves us having you guys have to put a lot of variables at the end of the link to try to specify what firewall it is, and mixing those variables up. We wanted to keep this very simple. After you've saved those two items out, you're free to use those two aliases in NAT policies. So it's as simple as just going over to Firewall, NAT, and then add a rule. And obviously you would pick WAN and your appropriate protocol for whatever you're forwarding or blocking. In the case of the whitelist, you can just use it as a source. You would simply pick single host or alias, type in the first letter, and there is your whitelist and blacklist ready to be applied to your rule. Now that works good for the whitelist. Now for the blacklist, if you want to blacklist all those IPs from connecting to anything in the network, all you have to do is go over here to Rules, add a rule at the top, and then I would just select any in the protocol box. And for the source, just pick single host or alias and the name of your blacklist. Hit save, and now your blacklist from pfMonitor will stop any attempt to connect to your networks from the IPs that you have assigned in that blacklist. So that's how you save and activate the rules in the blacklist and whitelist in your pfSense unit. Now as far as using it in pfMonitor, you'll find it under Settings and Global Access Lists. For the individual firewall rules, you'll find it under Per Device Access Lists. And here you just simply have whitelist and blacklist that are applied to all the firewalls uniformly. And it's as simple as clicking the plus button and adding a single IP address or a CIDR range to each list, and that would be immediately deployed out to all of your firewalls. On the per firewall access lists, you can actually select a firewall. Make sure you select a firewall before you click to add anything, otherwise it won't add anything to anything. After picking your firewall, the rules that are already on that firewall individually will show up in these lists if there are any. If you want to add a IP to allow or block, just hit the plus sign on whichever table you want to use. Type in your IP address with a CIDR range if you want. Otherwise, if you leave the CIDR specification off, it will automatically add a /32, which is the equivalent of saying just this one single IP. You can also add a comment so that you can remind yourself why this IP is in the list. After that, you just hit add, and that IP will now be in the list for that firewall. If you want to see if the ACLs have been applied to your firewalls, you can go over here to the ACL sync status. And here you will see the last time each firewall downloaded a whitelist, a blacklist, and the last time the threat data had incoming data. You may notice some of these dates are kind of strange. That's because I have not deployed the ACL and access lists to all of my firewalls yet. I think that about wraps it up for this video. Hope you guys are enjoying pfMonitor. Thanks. Bye.